So there's obviously lots of sketchbooks here in the print room. And one of the things I love about looking through some of these sketchbooks is realizing all the different reasons why artists use the sketchbook, the different purposes for the sketchbook. You know, from, you know, scribbling really quickly, doing 5 minute, even 1 minute drawings just to develop an idea, to, you know, more sustained kind, you know, studies of individual objects from life, working from memory, experimenting with different materials. So there are so many different reasons why using a sketchbook is so, so valuable. And looking through some of the sketchbooks here gives us a very interesting kind of glimpse into all those different reasons. And that's one of the reasons why I love the work of David Jones. And I think here we have a whole kind of process in play. So from some of the sketches he made, I think it was, well, from looking at the dates, it was from between the summer and the autumn of 1926, where he is first of all visiting Bristol Zoo. And, you know, I can imagine, well, animals are probably very difficult subjects to draw because, you know, they're moving about. So he's working very quickly, but obviously working from life, actually choosing animals that are resting, so makes the process a little bit easier, but actually, you know, collecting quite a lot of detail, you know, looking at light, looking at shadow, looking at tone, and then
the actual animals literally do move and position themselves.
Mm. So you can see that he's working from life and not from a photograph, for instance. You know, you get a real sense that he's actually there. And, you know, the fact that he's dating the work gives us a little bit of an insight into how he was working. Because some of these drawings are more developed.
And again, he's bringing in colour as well in some of these now.
Mm. So if we move along. So he starts off in Bristol Zoo. And then towards September, we can see that he's moved onto, he's in London, Zoo. This one in autumn 26. But I'm particularly fond of this one, of this camel. And this in turn informed a piece of, quite an extensive piece of work that he did, illustrating the deluge, Noah's Ark. And we can see one of the prints that he made from this drawing in this piece of work here. And you can actually see the same camel in this part of the print. This is a, printed from a wood block. But some of the pencil marks that he's done on the sketch, you can see that he's actually really transferred them onto the block. So you can see how one drawing then informs the woodcut, and we're lucky enough to have the actual block here as well.
Here's the block.
Yeah.
The original wood.
So you can actually see the little camel here.
And of course he's working in reverse.
Mm. You know, these are really fine lines, aren't they? So to see that whole process from beginning to the wood block to, you know, to the completed prints, that whole process itself is really interesting.
And to have them all here, to be able to look at them.